Bienvenue à tous.
Welcome to everybody for this interview for the film Rodin, directed by Jacques Doyon. We're delighted to have you here in Cannes with us today. Welcome. Welcome to your crew. Izia, welcome to you.
Bonjour Séverine.
And Séverine, welcome to you. Hello.
Bonjour.
And hello to Mr. Vincent Lindon. How are you doing, Vincent? I'm fine, thank you. Fine and dandy.
Great.
Jacques Doyon,
I
would like to welcome Séverine back here. Back in competition. We're delighted to see you here back in Cannes in the competition after an absence of 18 years. That was when you got your Best Actress Award for the Bruno Dumont film. So how are you feeling today? I'm delighted. I'm really happy. I'm tingling all over. And with this wonderful cast, it's great to be back.
Merci d'être là, Séverine.
Well, thank you for being here, Séverine. And thank you, Jacques, for bringing this actress back onto the screen for us. And thanks for showing us Rodin. What decided you to sculpt this portrait of Rodin? Why did you choose Rodin? Well, the sculptor is sitting next to me. But as far as Rodin is concerned, his work is not really well known. Since Michelangelo, he has been the most famous sculptor in the world, and there isn't a single film on him, on his life. So I stepped in. It's a scandal that there's not a film about his life. Well, there was the film, the Nutel film about Camille Claudel, which Rodin was in. Yes, but he was a secondary role, and that's not good enough. When your name is Rodin, you're not a secondary character. You need the lead role. Yes, so here you are with Vincent Lindon.
Rodin
is a man who works with his raw material, his clay. And he says he's a craftsman.
His
artistic ambition is excessive, but I think he's such a perfectionist. I think it corresponds quite well to you. How did you work the raw material of your Rodin? How did you sculpt your character? How did you prepare the role? Well, there are two things when I was playing Auguste Rodin. Firstly, I wanted to work with Jacques. 10 years ago, we made a film together, which didn't actually come to fruition. And then we've met, we've crossed walking down the street or in a cafe, and we have a similar way of feeling things and a similar way of looking at things. And we wanted to work together, and that was one of the reasons why I wanted to do this film. I wouldn't perhaps have done the film with any old director. And then there are two aspects. One aspect is in relationship with the actor, for example. I felt that I could do a deal with this character, and for it to be a good deal, you give something of yourself to the character. Well, it's a bit pretentious perhaps to say that I'm giving something to Rodin, but I just happen to be the actor, so I gave him my physique, the way I walk, the way I speak. He doesn't need all of those things, but because there's never been a film about him, well, then it just happens to be me who is supplying him with those things. And when you have this deal, it has to be a two-way deal, and I felt that I would be changed by playing that role. I'm not sure, I didn't know what he was going to give me, but he's allowed me to fine-tune certain things and detect the beauty that you find in work and the importance of believing in what you're doing, even if you're fighting against preconceived ideas. If you feel something, you just never ask anyone else's opinion. For me, an artist only does what he or she wants to do. And Rodin is a typical example of the artist who is doing exactly what he wants to do. And then the second hand, on the second level, it was an important choice to work with Jacques because of the way he films those long shots. Even you can't stand in front of the camera for 6 full minutes playing the role of Rodin and not be honest. There are certain scenes where the sculpture is evolving during the scene. And so I thought, well, how on earth am I going to do? And they said, well, go and learn how to sculpt. And to be successful. I had to go and learn how to sculpt so that I knew how to sculpt, and also to understand the feelings of a sculptor when you're kneading the clay, when your hands are so damp, when you're stroking, shaping. Just you have to look at something intensely without ever lowering your eyes. I've never looked into a camera for as long in my life. I usually find a way of looking away and looking sideways, but no, this time I had to look at the sculpture. And because Jacques was there opposite me with his camera, then I had to accept to hold that gaze. And I learned an awful lot. Yes, this is an artist who is really pig-headed and only does what he wants to do. Was that the case of Vincent in front of your camera? No, no, we got on really well. There were discussions. We got on really well and, you know, paid him enough money, so it was fine.
Camille Claudel. Comment vous l'avez abordé, Camille Claudel?
How did you justement, approach your role, given that you were playing alongside Vincent Landon as Rodin? I imagine you channeled your energy into the role. Is that what Jacques Doyon had asked you to do? Well, yeah, we met, and it was great feelings between us, and I think he perhaps recognized something of Camille in me. I imagine that's how it happened. Yes, you've got good energy, you've got a lot of imagination, and you've got this joy. For me, Camille Claudel had to be a joyous character, and if she hadn't been such a fiery character, she wouldn't have attracted an interest in Rodin. I do sculptures in the film, but I sculpt differently to Vincent. I saw the personal side of this young girl, a young woman who goes into this workshop. She's only 19. She's in love. There she is, her hands in the clay. She's extremely talented. She's gifted. So that's the side that interested me. I would just like to chime in here about my two co-actors here, my actresses here. When you're shooting, or when I'm shooting, I find it difficult to name the things I'm doing, why I'm an actor, why I'm doing what I'm doing, or why I'm walking around the set, and I can't really describe the relationship with the actresses. It's only afterwards that I manage to identify what drew me to both of these actresses. For Séverine, at one time in the film, she reassured me, probably because I was, she was playing the role of Rose, so the wife. Rodin's wife, well, not Rodin's wife, but someone who he married at the end of his life, 1 year before Rose died. But she was the woman who was in charge of the house. She kept things together. And I felt really comfortable with Séverine because I felt that she was Mrs. Rodin and she was there to cater for all of my needs during the film. And it was a kind of transfer. And for Isia, on the other hand, what I loved with Isia was that she had a kind of charming arrogance. She leaps around the place. She doesn't walk around normally. She jumps on you. She leaps on you. And she shouts at you. She laughs really loud. And she gets really offended very easily. And then she falls back in with you very, very quickly. Everything happens really, really quickly. And I've at last met someone who's fatter than me. So that was reassuring as well. So I thought, right, I'm not the fastest person in the world. So it was very pleasant. Very pleasant to work. It's because you're getting old. No, no, no. It's not a question of age. And Isia continues to tease. What a nice compliment Vincent has just paid you, Séverine, when you know what a career he's had, and you've only made five films, and you haven't made a film for the past 13 years, but you reassured him and you kept things together. Is that what you felt? Well, I was relieved to work with him. It was so easy to work with Vincent. And he helped me an awful lot too. And so we were helping each other. He also reassured me. He said things which really helped me to grow as well. And he was a great support. And with Izia, it was just fun. Every single day, it was great fun.
Toutes les deux, votre scène, elle est costaud.
So the relationship on screen is something pretty strong as well. Yes, but Séverine and I really got on very, very well together. And something really happened between us. The same that Vincent, she wasn't playing my wife,
but
there was a reassuring presence thanks to Séverine. So it was really hard to fight against her in the film because I didn't want to fight with her. I wanted to hug her. So we would comfort one another afterwards, and I'd apologize afterwards. But it was quite tricky to do those scenes. I would just like to add something about Jacques. I talked about my two actresses here.
Si je pense ça serait pléonastique de dire à quel point j'avais envie de travailler avec lui.
Of course you know I want to work with Jacques. He's a huge French director. So I'm not going to talk about his mise en scène, about the work, the films that he's made, all of his list of films, etc. I'm not going to waste our time talking about that. Everyone knows about that and everyone can talk about that. What I found most reassuring on set, and I think the girls felt this as well, and it's something which we don't see every day, we were being filmed by someone in whom we trusted. We don't wonder or worry about how he's filming, what he's thinking. I simply said when he was looking at us, he's got good taste, and it's rare to have good taste. That's all I needed to know. Things are in the right place at the right time. If he doesn't point anything out, there's no vulgarity, there's no facility or anything like that. Everything has to be beautiful from the overall I was wearing, the lighting, and it's wonderful to know that you are being looked at by someone who has good taste and takes the right decision. Actors are usually a bit dubious about that and are checking things, but I didn't need to do anything of that. Everything was way over my head. I don't think I even asked him once how I was during the take. Perhaps afterwards he might say a couple of words afterwards and show me how it was. I never came to me to ask questions about how things were going to be organized. Never, 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 never. It just was all so natural. I had complete trust in him. And I'm sure that makes it easier to create the character when you were so reassured. Christophe Boucan, who's in charge of the lighting, did a fabulous job. He's here with us. Let him come and say hello. And I really love the way you broach the sensuality of the bodies of your actors and Rodin's works when he's creating these works. A final little word, Jacques, perhaps.
Well, the unique thing about Rodin, the new thing about Rodin compared to all of his contemporaries, is that his bodies talk. And my cast had to be people that had bodies which would talk.
Un sentiment s'exprimant,
a feeling being expressed by the body, not only by the words, but by the body. And in this case, I found the right actors. And these are bodies that talk, and they talk so very elegantly. Thank you very much, Jacques, Vincent, Izia, and Séverine. Enjoy your film festival, and I'm really thrilled to see you here. In the studio, enjoy the film festival. We're going to continue talking about the film Rodin at the press conference in a few moments, and you can watch it on TV.